السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات، تجيب الدعوات، ترفيع الدرجات، رافع السماوات، وهو الذي يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويعفو عن السيئات، وهو الذي إلهنا وخالقنا ورازقنا وليس لنا رب سواه، بها نحيا وبها نموت. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في كلامه العزيز وفرقانه المجيد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. صدق الله مولانا الأمين. قال نبينا وحبيبنا صلى الله عليه وسلم: الصلاة عماد الدين، فمن هدمها فقد هدمها الدين، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. الحمد لله، all praise due to Almighty Allah سبحانه وتعالى. He is our sustainer and the nourisher and the provider and the protector. Peace and salvation be upon our beloved master, whom Almighty Allah سبحانه وتعالى has chosen him to guide the entire human being until the day of Qiyamah. And those who follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members and companions until the day of Qiyamah, whoever comes, for all of them, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. My dear respected friends, colleagues, brothers in Islam, today's topic is very important. Today's topic, there are many information, many things that we have to learn in this. We don't realize. We don't realize the gravity, the importance of it. That's why we are neglecting, we are not serious in our lives. So first and foremost, keep our intention pure, perfect, that inshallah, after this program, I will never miss a salah in my life. I will never ever going to leave a prayer in my life. Wherever, whatever I do, I will give first preference for my prayer, salah. Because so many things, so much effort has been taken to give, to get as a salah. It's very important. So my dear respected friends, this will be like interaction that I will be asking questions to them, from them, from y'all, whoever, that you have to keep in mind. If it's possible, y'all can note it down, the point what I am saying. First, we have to know there is two. Isra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Bani Israel, that is the 15th verse. Subhana alladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is confirming this. Allah says, asra is night journey. Asra means night journey. And other thing is mi'raj. It's called mi'raj. There's two things involved in it. One is night journey and mi'raj. From there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to mi'raj. So my respected friends in Islam, colleagues, when did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam go on this journey? That is the first question. First point we should know. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him, invite him. Like how, for example, if we get an invitation from president or queen, the king, whoever, an important person is inviting us, he will give VIP treatment. Invitation has come from a higher rank, so we will be happy. We'll be happy to go and see and visit and meet, get that chance and opportunity to go and shake hands, have some time, whatever. Right. So in that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, call me, come, I will honor you, respect you, and take something for your ummah. Take something when you're going back after this journey, that as a gift, you take it back. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are different narrations. When did he go? Some say in Ramadan, Shawwal. The final authentic saying, in the month of Rajab, 27th day, in the month of Rajab, Monday night, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on this journey. So you call this Isra. The Quran is also already mentioned, Isra. One is Isra, one is Mi'raj. Night journey, and from there he is going to meet Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when did he go? When he was going to this journey, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's age was 51 years. 51 years. And he went on this journey before Hijrah. 1.5 years before Hijrah. Before what is Hijrah? Migrating, right? Migrating where? Makkah to Medina. Good. So before the Hijrah, 1.5 years before, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got this invitation with honor, respect, and he got and is happy, ready himself, waiting to go. And 11 years after Nubuwwat, he got the Nubuwwat, he got the prophethood. After getting the prophethood, 11 years after this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the invitation, called him to go on this journey. So just imagine, got the prophethood after 11 years, he got this invitation, and how happy he will be to see Allah. He's going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's going to meet the Almighty Lord, the Creator, the Sustainer, the Provider, the everything. He's going to meet. Subhanallah. What a big chance and opportunity. Right. Now it starts from where he went. There should be a place to go. Actually, 51 years at that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after Isha, he was lying down. He was just taking a rest. In Makkah, Ummu Hani radiallahu ta'ala's house. Ummu Hani radiallahu ta'ala and her house was just lying down. What happened? Suddenly, Jibreel alayhi salam came. Jibreel alayhi salam came towards Rasulullah. Who is Jibreel alayhi salam? Who is Jibreel alayhi salam? He brings wahi, he brings revelation. Suddenly he came because the revelation, the Quranic verse, Allah says, Subhanalladhi asra bi abdihi. You can refer to that Surah Bani Israel, the first verse, first ayah. He's calling, come, you have to go for a journey. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you. Suddenly, how it will be? He didn't expect that. So before going to that journey, before taking him also, he should be a suitable person. Even Rasulullah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made as a result, as an example, as a lesson, that we also should take lesson from certain things happening in life. Before going to a place, before doing something, we have to prepare ourselves. For example, going for Hajj. What? We have to prepare ourselves, collecting money, physically, all these things. Fasting, Before fasting, we know that Ramadan is coming, we get elected. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also must prepare him. So what happened here? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying down and Jibreel alayhi wa sallam called him, come, come. And immediately, you know, in Kaaba, in Makkah, we see those who have been to Kaaba, Makkah, they will know. There's a wall, it's called Hatim. That is a part of Kaabatullah. In that, he was being lying and Jibreel alayhi salam picked his chest and washed his heart. Clean, purified. In Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's lifetime, three times his heart was being washed. Three times was first is while he was small, while he was childhood, while he was with Halima radiallahu ta'ala. Who's Halima radiallahu ta'ala? Rasulullah? Okay, good. Awesome. So what happened is suddenly, Rasulullah didn't know. While he was playing, suddenly Jibreel alayhi salam came, angel Jibreel alayhi salam came, and shakka sadr you call, fitting the heart, it's not like operating or no or whatever. Suddenly he got unconscious. And how did you get what? How did we what? Angels what? How? A plate from paradise, a gold plate from paradise, from Jannah, and washed with the Zamzam water. You must be knowing that. As a reminder, the incident. Then suddenly, wash the heart. That is the first time. Second purification of the heart was during the prophethood. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam getting the prophethood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala washed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not that he is a bad person. To purify him. To give a Nabi, prophet, he is going to get a responsible. It's very important. So this shows that no one is pure. We always do mistakes, wrong. So we rectify ourselves. Do tawbah, istighfar. Ask forgiveness from Allah. It is very important. Third time only this happened. So what happened? Lying on that hatim, in that wall, and split, washed with the Zamzam water, with a plate, golden plate, washed, but there's no mark in that. Nothing can be seen. Like operating, feeling nothing with it. It was easy. So from there, from Masjid al-Haram. Yeah, Masjid al-Haram is there. Where is Masjid al-Haram? Haram. Makkah, in Makkah. My respected friend, in youth in Islam, colleagues in Islam. In this dunya, in this earth, there are three places which is ancient and important place which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran, and we get more merit and reward when we are praying there. One is that Masjid al-Haram. How many rewards we get when you pray? How much reward we get when you pray in Makkah, Haram Sharif, for one rakat? Who can say? For one rakat, how much reward we get? Somebody else? For one rakat. Same? For one rakat in Makkah, in Haram Sharif, when you pray, what is the merit, what is the reward? 100,000, yes. And in Masjid al-Nabawi, Madina Sharif, when you pray for one rakat, how much reward we get? For one rakat, each rakat we pray, how much we get? 50,000, half of it. And the third masjid in Masjid al-Aqsa. Where is the Masjid al-Aqsa? Jerusalem. Yes. The famous place, Jerusalem, where most of the prophets have been buried there, from there, on the historical place. That's why it was in Muslims' hands, been captured with Yahudi Nasara, inshallah, by the time comes, the day of before the last session, we will get back. The Masjid al-Haram, Masjid al-Aqsa, we will get it back. You don't have to worry. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Holy Quran, Allah has mentioned that. That is no doubt at all. Right. So from there, from Masjid al-Haram, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Isra. Why is going? Why is taking? How did he go? Did he go just in a dream? Or did he go in the aeroplane? How did he go? How it happened? Who can tell? The vehicle. What kind of vehicle? Burak. Burak. You call that vehicle Burak. Burak. This vehicle is specially made only for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This vehicle is from Jannah, from paradise. Rasulullah, in the hadith, they describe about the vehicle. Like I said in the beginning, you get VIP treatment. Somebody is giving us invitation, how they will honor red carpet and all these things, like that. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, specially tailor-made only for Rasulullah, a vehicle, an animal. It is, we call, smaller than a donkey, bigger than a mule. Kind of horse, a description is given. I can imagine how it will be. So for example, we know a horse, how horse riding, how it will be fast. Something like that, a description has been given in Hadith Sharif. Smaller than a donkey and bigger than a mule. So it's in between. And it is white. Cannot even imagine, cannot even describe about the white. So pure, beautiful white. Because it's from paradise. It's from Jannah. Nobody has seen that before. Subhanallah. A special vehicle to go. So this happened after Isha prayer. So still is waiting. The vehicle also, Jibreel alayhi salam, Paul comes, watch the heart, and he's getting to the Burak. So called Burak. So that horse, that vehicle is such fast. No one can imagine the fast, the speed. From each step, it goes far beyond our eyesight. So fast. So that's why sometimes Islam and deen might think, how can he go daily from Isha to Subuh, only small between few hours, 6 hours, 7 hours. In this between, he is gone to Isra, from Makkah to Jerusalem, and from there he has gone to heaven. How can it happen? Practically we might think, people might think. During the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the mushrikeen, non-Muslim, disbelief, they thought like that. They thought like that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do things what? With means, without means, and against means. Can do miracles. Right? Allah, for us only we need these and that reason. You know. For example, I can give. Can tell. Allah shows everything. Adam alayhi salam. Who is Adam alayhi salam? He is a prophet, first prophet. Who is he? He is our father of everyone. Father of everyone. Father of all. So Allah created him who? How did Allah create him? No father, no mother. Allah created him from the sand, from the soil. And Hawa alayhi salam? Who is Hawa alayhi salam? Huh? His wife. Now mother. How did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create it? With a father, there is no mother. Right? Said Allah, that also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told. And how Isa alayhi salam, Maryam alayhi salam has been born? How Maryam alayhi salam Allah born? No father, no mother. Kun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this country. Allah showed, which means I can do. Nothing is impossible for him. Allah showed that. After that, as normal, the world, that which means that father and mother get together, as a child has been born, through that means. You don't fall from the sky. So that's in the dunya end, the world end, that will happen in that country. So Allah can do miracles. Right. Now, that vehicle, now Burak is there. That vehicle is refusing to take Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The moment Rasulullah got into the vehicle, that Burak is refusing. Struggling, no, it's struggling and trying to throw out Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Pushed it. You can see it's refusing. Adamant, can't like that. Then Jibreel alayhi salam says suddenly, Jibreel alayhi salam knocked on that animal and vehicle and say, you know who is this? This is the Prophet of Allah. Prophet of Allah. So please, take him. Prophet of Allah. Respect him. Honor him. Then the Burak, that animal, put a condition. No, I can't. Why? What will happen to me now? Only for this purpose? Only for this purpose I have been created from the heavens, then Rasulullah will go to Isra and Mi'raj and come back and leave me alone. I can't do that. I need something assurance. If Rasulullah is going, I need some condition. I need some condition. If you fulfill my condition, then I will take. What is the condition? He said, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used me, going to Isra and Mi'raj, coming back, that nobody else must use me. I will only go with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have to go back, return back to Jannah. That condition, the burakul. And finally Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, okay, no problem. Jibreel alayhi wa sallam said, yes, your condition will be fulfilled, will be accepted. What happened? After the Mi'raj, that Isra journey finished, Burak, that animal has been in Jannah, what will happen? In the day of Qiyamah, in the day of resurrection, Jibreel alayhi salam again will take that Burak to Qabr, to the Qabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come out from the Qabr and get into the, that Burak, and from there, the Burak, that animal will take to Jannah, paradise. There is a specialty. Nobody has seen. There is a specialty. There is a condition. Subhanallah. So only for Rasulullah. Once it's been used, now it's in paradise. Again, the day of Qiyamah is the day of resurrection. Because, as we know, only Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the one first is going to enter to paradise. Jannah. Until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enters, for other sahab, nabis or others, it's haram for them to enter. Right. Now, the condition is accepted. Agreement is agreed. Okay, we'll take. So now while going, there are certain incidents. It's going fast, going, you know, when we are going, sceneries we can see. Beautiful sceneries, we can ask what is this, what is, if you go, a tour guide will take, for example. The tour guide is going to stop, this is the place, where it happened, like that. So Rasulullah salam, along with Rasulullah, Jibreel alayhi salam, and Mikail alayhi. VIP, two bodyguards in that region. They were escorting, they both were going along with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And while going, Rasulullah asked to stop in a place called Madian. Madian is, it's in Jerusalem, somewhere closer to that part. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked to stop. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed two rakat there. So Madian is the place where Musa alayhi salam born. Musa alayhi salam birthplace. Like Makkah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam birthplace, Madian, Musa alayhi salam. Okay. Prayed there and again he got into the vehicle, again good. While he's going, he is asked to stop in another place called Baitul Laham. Baitul Laham. In that place, he prayed two rakat, and where Isa alayhi salam been born. Isa alayhi salam birthplace. So these are the incident while going. So this everything is not a story. Yeah? What I'm saying is, in Bukhari, Muslim, Hadith, Kitab, Miskat, it's there. If you want, you all can refer under the chapter of Isra and Mi'raj. Detailing study. Now, while he's going, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard a noise, salam voice. From the right side, he heard a salam, somebody saying salam, giving salam. So Jibreel alayhi wa sallam said, don't reply for the salam. Don't reply for the salam. He asked him to keep quiet. Okay, while he's going again, he heard a noise, voice from left hand side, assalamu alaikum. Jibreel alayhi wa sallam said, not to answer the salam. Not to answer the question. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, why? It's a salam. Why you are saying not to do it? Then Jibreel alayhi salam gave detailed explanation for that. If you would have answered that salam, the person, the people who gave salam from the right side, those are the people, Jewish people. Jewish people. So, they will accept your salam, they will answer your salam, reply to your salam and they will go misguided. They will be misleaded. And the people who gave salam from the left side, they are Nasara, Christians. So, it's not nice. So, they are salam, you reply, and if those people go astray, it's not nice. So, that's better be quiet and silent. So when? So why is he going in this? It's a journey. Still, he's going. He didn't go and reach the destination. Where's the destination? Where is he supposed to go? Yeah. Allah. And before that? Before that, there's a destination place. Top place. Yeah. Masjidul Aqsa. Masjidul Aqsa in Jerusalem. Right. So while he's going, he saw a beautiful lady. Now, it's like scenery, new things. Then he's asking by Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam said, don't see that, don't look at that. Those are the things, dunya, worldly life. Worldly life, dunya is, will mislead us, will cheat us, how can I say, will deceive us, is deceived. So those are things, dunya, don't see, don't look at. Then again, while going, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw old lady, old person. Then Jibreel alayhi salam thought, Jibreel alayhi salam said, this is the life of dunya. Life of dunya, the age limit of dunya. For example, a person, how long he will live? 80, maximum 90. That is the age, lifespan of dunya. So, example showing that. So, my dear respected brothers, friends in Islam, so there is a story behind this. Incident behind this, right? So, it's going on. Then he went and reached the destination. Where is the destination? Masjid al-Aqsa. He went and passed the bura, the animal. Where? He tied and he kept there. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw all the prophets. From the first Nabi, Adam alayhi salam. Who is the last Nabi, last prophet? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw all the prophets. They are waiting in Masjid al-Aqsa. Jerusalem, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned them to be there. We might have a doubt, they have died and dead and gone, why this should be? Allah can do things, miracles. We cannot question Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things happen. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went there, he prayed 2 rakat. He conducted prayer, imamat. He conducted prayer. Why hadith says, Ana imamun nabiyyin. I am the imam for all the prophets. So this example, this shows by practical. All the nabis, they were praying behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when Rasulullah is doing imamat, Jibreel alayhi salam called for the azan and ikamat, whatever that time calling towards the prayer for the normal formality. So, right front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, behind the imam, behind Adam alayhi salam was standing. And in the right side, Ismail alayhi salam, Prophet Ismail alayhi salam was standing. In the left side, Prophet Ismail alayhi salam was standing. See, how many things? So why? Rasul Adam alayhi salam, he is the father of everyone, the entire mankind, human being. To respect it, right behind. Why is Ibrahim alayhi salam? Ibrahim alayhi salam is the father of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The deen, the religious who introduced. He was to respect in right hand side. Why Ismail alayhi salam? Why other nabis would have come? Why specifically these 3 people? Ismail alayhi salam, the reason why? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came from the whose family lineage? Whose family lineage? Ismail alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam had 2 sons, Ishaq alayhi salam was there. So prophet came through from Ishaq, Ismail alayhi salam, because of that. So, the chosen, the respect given for this, subhanallah. So he conducted 2 rakat prayers. Immediately after the prayer finished, Jibreel alayhi salam offered, brought him 3 vessels, 3 bowls, in case, 3 bowls. In one, there was water. In one, there was milk. In one, there was wine. Some narrative say 2 bowls of. 2 bowls was been offered. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finally chose the bowl which has milk on it. Subhanallah. So the moment Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose that, Jibreel alayhi salam said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi, Alhamdulillah, hadaka Lilfitra. The meaning of this dua. All praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadaka lilfitra. Who guided Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to choose the fitra? The milk. He would have taken the water or the wine. Immediately. And the reason Jibreel alayhi salam saying, Ya Rasulullah, because you chose the milk, your entire ummah, nation, people will go to Jannah, paradise, those who follow you. If you would have chosen the wine, drunk the wine, all the people, entire man, human being, mankind, they will be going to astray, Jahannam, hellfire. If you would have chosen water, they would have, this ummah will be destroyed by the water. So that is the interpretation given behind it. Why? What happened? So it's a lesson. It's a journey. You learn. That's what. When we travel, we can learn a lot. By traveling, we can learn, we can memorize many things, experience. Very important. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, As-safaru kita'atun min al-azab. Safar. Traveling is there. Part of a journey is part of a hellfire. Punishment. Because while traveling, you will feel the difficulties. So when you travel to a good purpose, Allah will give you reward. You can shorten the prayer. All the benefits you are getting. When you travel for a bad purpose, intention, it's sin. So that is the sign. Fine. Now, it's done. Now, did he go to Mi'raj to meet Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Buraq? Did he go? How did he go there? Who can tell? Now he went from Makkah, from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, Jerusalem, and he parked the Buraq vehicle inside there. And he prayed. He did all this, happened what I said. Now he's going there. No, he didn't go in the Buraq. He didn't go in the Buraq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the heaven, shorter, brought down up to such extent that he could climb, like going towards the steps. When we climb, when we go up in the mountain, like that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made easy for him. Come with. So now he went. Jibreel alayhi salam is taking. He went to where? First heaven, right? First heaven he went there and knocked the door there. Then Adam alayhi salam. The first heaven, who was there? I will ask again. Repeat, who was there? Whatever, I'll go back and ask questions. So who was there in the first heaven? Adam alayhi salam. So Adam alayhi salam is asking, who is this? And Jibreel alayhi salam says, please open the door. Then Adam alayhi salam is asking, who has come with you, along with you? Jibreel alayhi salam says, Prophet of Allah, Nabi of Allah has come along with you. Is he the person who guided good person, who the Prophet of Allah, Allah chose him to give the prophethood? Yes, the same person. Then he opened the door. And he gave salam. Assalamu alaikum. So, for the salam, reply was given from Adam alayhi salam. And what did Adam alayhi salam say? Ya Rasulullah, Ya Nabi Allah, that I bear witness that you are the Nabi. You are the Prophet of Allah. Because everyone will believe. Even the last Nabi, everyone. This incident shows that all will follow. Even see, Isa alayhi salam will come. As we believe, the last session, when the Dajjal, when the day of Qiyamah is starting, Isa alayhi salam will come, Mahdi alayhi salam will come, then Dajjal will come. So Isa alayhi salam, will he come as a prophet or as a follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How he will come? He will come as a follower of Rasulullah. Ummat of Rasulullah, he will come. Then he's asked. Then, he saw Adam alayhi salam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw towards right side of Adam alayhi salam, people, and he gave salam and smiled. And towards the left side of Adam alayhi salam, prophet, he saw and cried, wept over, cried. And he gave explanation, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Nabi Allah. The right side people, that is your followers, in your ummah, in your people, that who will follow you, they will go to Jannah, good people. The left side, who are the sinners, non-disbelievers, they will go to enter hellfire, the fire. So that is that. Now he's going where to? Second heaven. Second heaven, the same incident happened. Second heaven, who is there? Prophet Yahya alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam was there. Two prophets were there. Two prophets in the second heaven. Same thing happened. Going and tapping the door. Assalamu alaikum. Rasulullah has come. Please open the door. And they also give salam alaikum as-salam. And they respond to the salam and say, Ashhadu annaka nabi Allah. I bear witness. That is, you are the Nabi of Allah. Nabi of Allah. Second heaven. The third heaven. Third heaven. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into the third heaven. Jibreel alayhi wa sallam said, open the door. Who has come? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has come. The third heaven. Yusuf alayhi wa sallam was there. Who? Prophet Yusuf alayhi wa sallam was there. Same thing happened. Give salam and reply and say that you are the Nabi of Allah. We bear witness. Shadu annaka Nabi Allah Muhammad Rasulullah. The fourth heaven, same thing happened. What? When knocked the door, Idris alayhi salam was there in fourth heaven and gave salam, replied to him, wa alaykum as-salam, then say that you are the Nabi of Allah, we bear witness. And another funny thing happened in the fourth heaven. There one man, one person, was sitting with like face, a funny face, angry face, like, you know, he's very serious. Serious, not smiling with anyone. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is this person? Ask, who is this person? He is only, who will take our roof? Who is taking our roof, our soil, and dies? Israel alayhi salam. He is only Malakul Maud. He is the person. He is the main person. He is very serious. Malakul Maud is there. He was there in the fourth heaven. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, you are Israel alayhi salam, and how are you taking people's roof? The whole world, see, people are dying at once. How are you taking? How is it possible? Then he explained, he further explained, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made me in such, in one eye, one glance, I could see the entire world, entire people through. Right? I could see. Then whoever the order comes, immediately I will take from them. It's easy. So when the plate comes, you can reach, you can take it. So that's how I am doing it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it, need to do it. Subhanallah. So this is also the same. So my dear respected friends in Islam, then where are we now? In which heaven? Fourth. Now we are going to the sixth heaven. Fifth heaven. Who was there in fifth heaven? Who was there? Who can say? Who can tell? Fifth heaven, which prophet? Which Nabi was there? Who? Harun alayhi salam. Prophet Harun alayhi salam was there. Fifth heaven. So the same formality happened. Give salam. Assalamu alaikum. Alaykum as-salam. I bear witness that Ashhadu annaka Nabi Allah. You are the Nabi, Prophet of Allah. And formality happened. And the sixth heaven now. Going to sixth heaven. Going, he's climbing. He's going up. Then like I said, Allah made things easy. Like he's climbing. He said, how you have gone up? Oh, you can't see. The sky is not easy. Even flying so much. We can't think that. Beyond imagine our imagination. Allah can do things. Like I gave examples, few examples. With means, without means, if Allah intends, Allah wills, Allah will do anything. You don't have to be reasoned out. Right. And now the sixth heaven. Who is in the sixth heaven now? Which prophet? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Prophet Musa alayhi salam. He also gave salam. Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum as-salam. Bear witness that you are the prophet of Allah. Formality happened. And funny thing, he starts crying. He starts crying, lifting. He starts crying and he said, Ya Rasulullah, that he was a Nabi. In my ummah, there are many youngsters, many followers, but they all will go to the hellfire. But there is a Nabi prophet after me who will come, and there are followers, all of them will go to Jannah. He was crying and he was reasoning out. A young Sahabi, a young Nabi will come, and all will follow. That is preferring Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right. That sixth heaven is gone. Now the last stage. What is the last stage? The seventh heaven. Like Allah we created. Allah says in the Quran, خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ. Like seven heaven and seven earth. سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ تِبَاقًا. They will be steps, stages, right? The seven. Who was there? Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam was there. Same thing happened. Giving salam. Assalamu alayka ya Rasulullah. Wa alaykum assalam. Giving salam. So see, many things. You know, from the beginning, so how many things they have learned? How many information? You think, oh, Miraj, night journey, this just happened. Details. So these are a lesson for us. Fine. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, where was he? Now the point. Now he's right top now. Ibrahim alayhi salam was lying down and waiting in Baytul Ma'mur. Place called Baytul Ma'mur. Baytul Ma'mur is a place where right above the Kaabatullah, Arshat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was lying there. Baytul Ma'mur. Baytul Ma'mur, Allah says in the Quran, Wal Baytul Ma'mur, Wastaqfil Marfu, Wal Bahril Masjur, in Surah Najm, I think that ayah comes. Allah says it. From Baytul Ma'mur, every day, 75,000 malaika, angels coming down to earth. And those angels, not going back also. So much of creation, malaika, angels doing tawaf, the Baytul Ma'mur, protection, waiting. So from there, after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Hijratul Muntaha, that is the last destination, the purpose of this journey. Sidratul Muntaha, you call Sidratul. Sidratul Muntaha means it is a tree from paradise. Tree of paradise. Sidratul Muntaha. Now Jibreel alayhi salam is telling, now he is as a tour guide, he is supporting, going along with him, and he can't go beyond that. Why? Now Jibreel alayhi salam is refusing to come. He's saying, Ya Rasulullah, I don't have permission to come beyond this. If I come, I will get married. Allah has never given me. Please stay. Rasulullah is calling. But I can't come. There is no permission. I will stay here. And I will watch what you are doing. What your conversation, what is happening, all this. So, Sidratul Muntaha is a tree. How it is a huge tree. And the branches and the leaves. The leaves. In the hadith, they describe a size of a leaf is elephant ears. One got huger than that. Huger than that. Just to get an idea of it. Huger than the elephant ears. And one leaf. So in that tree, many branches, many leaves. What is the reason behind this? Why this Sidratul Muntaha? Why this tree should be there? That tree, in that tree only, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept everyone in the whole world, people's names in that. Each leaf, people's name, the ruh is there. When the ruh has been taken from that tree, the leaf will fall. That leaf will fall and go towards the Israel alayhi salam. So one by one, it is there, will get reduced. The whole world, the Qiyamah comes, then the tree will get that vanished. That is the reason behind this Sidratul Muntaha, this tree. Subhanallah. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Sidratul Muntaha and meet Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we will have a question whether Allah, Rasulullah saw Allah, Almighty Allah, directly, yes, directly saw. Quran says, فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَيْنِ أَوْ أَدْنَى وَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى إِسُرَ نَبِي الْإِسْوَسَ. So closer. Directly, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a conversation, spoke, talked to each other. The light. And how, in which format, these are details we can discuss, it goes, when you think so. Then how Rasulullah saw, how Allah was as a human being form or whatever. We cannot make a formation for Allah. They say, the scholars say, they give interpretation that a light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the noor, the light, that is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw, and direct. Right. Then, Rasulullah gave salam, assalamu alaykum, ya Allah. Right? So the salam, the response is coming from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah gave salam how? At-tahiyyatu lillahi. At-tahiyyatu lillahi. At-tahiyyat is tahiyyat. We greet. Oh, at-tahiyyatu lillahi. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately replied, As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi. Allah replied, Oh, salam, peace be upon, salam upon your nabi. Subhanallah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't stop from there. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked dua more than that. Not only me, my entire ummah, my entire people also should get this blessings and salam of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, that's it. As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. So until the day of Qiyamah, whoever is mu'mins, believers, salihin, subhanallah. So three things happen, three conversations. At-tahiyyatu lillah, salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Allah. Allah is replying, wa as-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyu. Nabi's word, ayyuhan nabi. And third, Rasulullah is not selfish. Rasulullah always thought about the ummah. Oh, my ummah, my people, subhanallah. So, listening to this conversation, seeing this conversation, Jibreel alayhi salam was very, very happy. Very shocked. No. He, out of his happiness, said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu, said. Jibreel alayhi salam's word. Jibreel alayhi salam starts screaming and saying, subhanallah. How is it? Now, this word, this verses, where we are reading? Where we are reading? Huh? In At-Tahiyyat, in prayer. See, where it is. To remember, as a significant, every prayer, this Allah's conversation, this Prophet's conversation, dua, Jibreel alayhi salam. So now we learn, where it starts. At-Tahiyyatu lillahi, that Rasulullah, As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi, that Allah taught, Allah said, Ashhadu an la ilaha wa alayla. Four words, four conversations, four different, all together, we are saying At-Tahiyyat. It is wajib, compulsory upon us to read At-Tahiyyat in the prayer. If you don't read At-Tahiyyat, our prayer is not accepted. So now while going, he saw in Jannah now, this is in Sidratul Muntaha, he saw rivers that coming, water is flowing, four rivers. Nahrani, the hadith says, Nahrani, Jariyani, Batinani, Zahirani, two rivers coming from Jannah. All the rivers are starting from Jannah. Two rivers we can be seen where it is going. That is in the dunya, in the world, that the river of Nile and Furat. That two rivers, it is Zahirani. We can be seen that where it is going. That is in the world. Nile and Furat is in Egypt. There's the Musa alayhi salam story, where Musa alayhi salam mother put in the Nile. That story, long story. That Furat is also there. So this two river in this world. Another two river in Jannah. That is Batinani. That going towards Jannah. That is that in the river that we see in the hadith of Jannah that we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rivers running with water, I mean, with wine. With milk, all the kind of stuff. So Jannah is a different topic. Can describe and keep on speaking. Fine. Now it's happened, it's finished. No? Everything is finished, now it's coming back. Finished? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, finally, when he's coming back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave three gifts for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's very important. Yeah? You're going, no? You take these three gifts from me. It's happy. Somebody comes, he honoring the spectrum as a gift. Hadiya. Right. So what is the first gift? Who can tell? What is the first gift? Huh? Prayer. How many times was there? In the beginning, how many times was there? 50 times. 50 times. So, when he's coming back, Musa alayhi salam, stop and ask Rasulullah, Ya Rabbi Allah, how many times Allah made prayer? He said, 50 times. He said, please go. It is difficult, Ummah, one pray. 50 times difficult, go and ask. And he went and again and asked before coming. Before going in to the Makkah. To go and ask and reduce it. So reduce from 50 to 10. Again go, you please beg. It came till finally 5. Then again he said, go and reduce him, go and ask for the police. And he said, I can't. Hereafter, I can't. I have same though that I don't have, can't. There's a amount or there's a limit. How much you can go and ask? Then he stopped there. He said, that's why 5 times prayer today. So he came back. So when he came back now, the Mushrikeens are waiting there. To other. First, this what you call the gift prayer. Second gift is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked as a condition. He said, no, you give 3 gifts, whatever you ask, I will give you. The second gift is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that I will forgive your entire ummah's sin. Allah promised, if Allah give a word, Allah will never misuse, Allah will never take back. Wa'ada Allah, Allah says in the Quran. Wa'ada Allah, the words of Allah, inna Allah la yukhlisul miyad. He will never change. We might change and give reason, whatever, no, can't. Allah will stick to the word. Allah says, I will forgive. So keeping that to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, argue, Ya Allah, you said you will forgive the ummah, please forgive entire ummah. But one condition, they must not have you shirk with me. Shirk is what? Associating? Partner with Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, in the Quran also, Allah hates, Allah gets angry. Because Allah is one. If you associate partner, how it will be? Like the idol worshippers, they have for each one, they believe and they do shirk. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُوا أَيُّشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُوا مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ in the Quran. Even an oppressor, even a person is doing oppressing, Allah will forgive. The third gift, Surah Baqarah, the last verse, what is the آمَنَ الرَّسُولُ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that entire verse, that is the gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave for the ummah, that the entire story, what happened between Allah and Rasul, the conversation, the story of Miraj, to prove that. You can go refer to the translation, see. Kullu namana billah wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi lan. The entire story is there, you can refer, see the translation. Right. Then now, people are waiting to tell story. Ah, Muhammad has come, Prophet has come. He is saying that he went to Jerusalem and that's all. How can it be? Now they want to argue with him, face to face, interview him and put him down in front of everyone. They went and told Abu Bakr Siddiq. See, Prophet is saying this. He has gone to Masjid al-Aqsa and Miraj and all these things. And what did Abu Bakr Siddiq say? Rasulullah says, Nabi of Allah says, it is true. I will accept. That's why his name is As-Siddiq. Abu Bakr Siddiq. Immediately accept. It was being said to Umar Ali Allah Ta'ala. So Umar Ali said, okay, I will rectify. I will go and speak to him and ask him, let you know. So, stop the eyes. So immediately he accepted of Siddiq, the name, until the day of Qiyamah. Then, after that, now people ask him questions. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala made him that, now they ask him question like, Allah made in such way that he is looking at screen, because he can't remember. Anything happened while going, he saw the that and these, all these things. He can't eat. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept front of like a screen. He's watching a screen and looking. He said the color, the masjid, that, everything detail he mentioned. Up to such a thing he mentioned, from Jerusalem, there is a caravan is coming. Such amount of camel, such amount of people are also coming now on the way. Why is he telling that caravan where those people came and landed? They were shocked. Oh, what? But still they didn't accept. They didn't accept because they had that arrogance. They didn't accept. So my dear respected friends and youth in Islam, so many things took place in the Miraj. After everything, after all the effort, the value only, the salah has been given. So this salah, are we ready to leave it? Just misuse it? No. So this salah is given as a gift for us directly to ask from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we need something, to ask directly, pray 2 rakat, the connection from Allah, Allah will give us. Previous nations, the ummah, they never had this. They never had this what? They never had to ask, to pray. They will say the Nabi, and the Nabi Prophet of Allah will go and ask. So now, the question is, what was the prayer started, first prayer? Subah or Dhuhr? Now you say, Subah. What was the prayer? Subah, Lohat. Why Lohat? Because we are praying Subuh. Subuh is the first prayer. The reason is, there was no time. Fajr time, there is not enough time. Now the prayer has been given, but he, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't know how to pray. Take wudu, there is a way of praying, ruku, sujood and everything. So, next day Jibreel alayhi salam came, come ya Rasulullah, I will show you. And from the rock, water came, the spring water. This how you take wudu, this how you take wudu, and take two wudu, this how you pray. Jibreel alayhi salam conducted the prayer, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed behind. The first day. First day, same time, five times he came. That he came to time of Duha, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Four rakat, two, three, like that he came. Next day what he did? Next day he came late. From the day, first day he came on the earliest time. When the Lohar Azan is going on, he came. Next day he came closer to Asr, closer to Maghrib, closer to Isha, closer to Subuh. And he came, he conducted prayer, Chikudu same. And the reason he came and he said, Ya Rasulullah, this is how you pray. The day, first day I came, that is the awwal waqt, the beginning time, start. Then the second day I came, that is the last, the salah is finishing, qada. The gap is there between Lohar and Asr, Maghrib and Isha. So that's what, very important. So that's what we get more reward, merit on it, why? When you pray on time, with Imam Jamaat. With Imam Jamaat when you pray. So my respected friends in Islam, it is very important, it is such that Salah has been given to us. So many hadith is there. So much of hadith, virtue. After such taking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the person who is not praying, doesn't have part in Islam. Don't even bury him in the burial ground, Makbara. The Salah, its objective was being given for us. Why? To show the difference between Allah and ourselves. Who are we? We are the servant of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are abd. We have been given only permission to do sujood, prostrate to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah is something we are having conversation with Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment we say Takbir Allahu Akbar, until we give salam, everything is haram. We can't speak, we can't eat, we can't answer anything. Salam, we have to concentrate. It's very important. Take this. And we ask everyone, what is the second pillar of Islam? Easily, Salah. But how far, how much we are punctual in the Salah. Praying is very important. So it's very important. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you are praying, you think, this is my last prayer. This is my last Maghrib prayer, so I'm going to die. Just imagine, you got a news that this is your last prayer, you prayed properly, after that you are not going to pray. So how you will pray? We will concentrate, we will take our own time. Just imagine, our Salah now how? When we say Takbir, we remember everything. We go everywhere, all the world. We remember. That can be, it should not be like that. So that's why the scholar says, to bring the concentration, you remember, you think, you know that what I am reading is that the meaning. Surah Fatiha, see, Surah Fatiha is a dua. It's a dua and asking guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you read Surah Fatiha, Allah says, my servant praised me, my servant did me, I am giving this. It's a dialogue between us and Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very important. So for that, we have to, there's many verses. Salah is a light for us, noor for us. When we pray five times Salah, our face is light. Salah is key to paradise. Without Salah, we can't do it. Salah is a mi'raj for mu'min. Many words. You take the chapter of volume in Bukhari, Muslim, you take the chapter of prayer, there are many hadiths encouraging. So a person who prays here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prays five times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, five things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take responsible. First responsible, Allah says, I will make things easy, everything, your food, your sustenance, all the things, all the needs, I will make things easy. So success, you want success? Go, pray to Raka. That's why Rasulullah says, from 7 years onwards, we have to pray, command. 10 years, Rasulullah says to the parents, fathers, punish them if they don't pray. We can't say, there is nothing called kala, it's missed, no, I don't have to. No, you pray. You miss, you pray. When you are traveling, Allah says, you shorten the prayer. So much facility has been given. You can't stand and pray. Sit and pray. You can't sit and pray, sleep and pray. Think. It's very important. Very important. Significant. I think last week the match was going on. Is that Afghanistan team. They asked permission. 5 minutes permission and they got permission. They pray Salat in congregation, Jamaat. That's it. We are Muslim. Wherever we are, we must not sacrifice our Islam, our prayers, our practical things for dunya, for silly things. Very important. You must show, you must be proud, I am a Muslim. That is very important. We don't pray, there is no difference between us and non-Muslims. Very important. So my respect, my final humble advice that protect the Salah, keep on praying and keep speaking to myself also. And many rewards. See, the person prays Fajr prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes responsible the entire day. If you don't pray, then shaitan will be with you. Trouble, you will go to school, all the problems will come. You pray Fajr, you have a gun. Nothing will happen to you. Allah will protect you. And when you pray Fajr prayer, see, congregation, Jamaat, you get reward the half of the night that you worship. When you pray Isha, Imam Jamaat, that you will get reward half of the night, the whole night. And the Fajr prayer, the Isha prayer is a difficult prayer for the munafiq, hypocrite. Like that. No one. And pray the Nafl prayer, Sunnah prayer. So by, if something goes wrong, mistakes in the Fard prayer, from the Sunnah, Nafl prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take and fulfill all this. So may Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of us, whatever has been spoken. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the gathering. Wa akhir da'wana.